Good morning everyone and welcome to today's market commentary. So this is Nifty's daily time frame chart and we can see that the prior trend line support is now acting as trend line resistance. On Friday as well as today we can see the high made of both these candles are touching exactly the trend line resistance, and then today we can see there's a good fall in Nifty from the high made today. Not only that, the prior rectangle, if we just move it towards the right side, so price is not able to sustain above this prior support zone. So once this long red candle which broke this prior support, now this prior support will act as a resistance this time. So until and unless price is not able to sustain above this rectangle or above this trend line support, one cannot be bullish on Nifty. So this is the first idea that we are getting from daily time frame chart, and if we go back to our weekly time frame, so price is still in between this congestion zone. So whatever the candle which we have got on weekly time frame starting from this swing high, this was a shooting star. The color of the candle doesn't matter here, but this is a shooting star. So that is a bearish candlestick pattern, and this is a hanging one, even that is also a bearish candlestick pattern. So last week also we did not have a satisfactory bullish trend in Nifty. So until all these bearish indications are gone from weekly chart, we cannot be bullish on Nifty. Now if you see, if you just shift back to our basic line chart, so the pattern here resembles a double top pattern. So in this line chart, only closing price is considered. So we can clearly see that there is a closing, common closing price every week. So until this common closing price is not taken out, one cannot be bullish on Nifty. So that is the major common point that we could see on weekly time frame. And on daily time frame, we can see that there are many resistances for Nifty on the upper side. So basic horizontal resistance and trend line resistance, Nifty is not able to surpass. Now enabling our pivot point indicator, if you see, this is the first day of this pivot points. Because today it is July 2nd, the 2nd of the month and first trading day of this current month. So these pivot points are valid for a whole month since this is a daily time frame chart. And from the starting of today's session, price is trading below the central pivot point. So that is a bearish indication. Now one more important point which you can observe here is this month's S1 is coinciding with the prior swing low. So this is the strongest support zone for Nifty which we drew earlier. So if you see, all these three candles share the common low. So in this zone itself we have S1 of this month. So the best position for some a bullish entry would be at this S1. So in between this you should not enter any bearish position or bullish position, but when price comes down and takes a good support near this S1, that would be the best point to enter or to be on the bullish side, keeping this prior swing low as your stop loss. And this prior swing low is also somewhere around S2 of this month. So that should be your stop loss, and you should enter your bullish positions here. And then we can expect again Nifty to take a bounce back. Now when price reaches at this point, so first point is there is a natural support and there is also a pivot point S1. So at this point only, if we get a very good bullish divergence in Nifty, then that will be a sure shot bullish signal in Nifty. So that is what we need to wait for. But currently it is in inside this congestion zone where we cannot establish any bullish or bearish position. Now going to lower time frame. So yes, even on hourly time frame also, if candle comes down here and if you have a very good bullish divergence, that is the best point you need to enter within the hourly time frame itself. And then it will give you a very good risk to reward trade. So we shall wait for that opportunity. And as of now, we don't have any clear bearish or bullish signal based on RSI indicator. Even on hourly time frame, so these pivot points are valid for this week. Even in this time frame also, price is trading below the central pivot point, so that is also a bearish signal. Now see the point of coincidence here. On daily time frame also, we had S1 at the zone, and even on hourly time frame also, for this week we have S1 at the same zone. So now all the indicators and even the plain chart horizontal support is also indicating that this zone is going to be a very strong support zone for Nifty. All it is doing is coming down, giving opportunity for new participants who wants to be on bullish side so that they can reduce their risk here. So it is giving you a new chance to enter. So enter bullish positions here once we have a bullish divergence on hourly time frame. So I'm just repeating everything for the newcomers who have joined the commentary just now. First thing, on weekly time frame, we did not have any satisfactory bullish positions because price was making double top pattern, and that too on closing basis. That is, if we shift back to line chart, which depends only on the closing price, we could see that on the top, price is sharing a common close price. So that is a signal of pure bearishness. Even on daily time frame, the trend line resistance is acting as a strong resistance, and prior support is also acting as a resistance now. So majorly on weekly and daily time frame, price is indicating bearishness. But on the downside, what we could see is we have a very strong support. So on daily time frame, so this is our very strong support zone. There is a horizontal support, and there is also a support based on pivot points because we have S1 here. Next, in the lower time frame, that is on hourly time frame, same again, we have pivot point in the same zone. So if Nifty is coming back here to this zone, and if it is exhibiting any bullish divergence on RSI, so that will be the best point for you to enter because it is coming down to natural support zone, and there are monthly and weekly pivot point S1 at the same zone. And if it also forms a bullish divergence in the same zone, that would mean that it is giving you a chance to enter early in the coming bullish rally. And on 15-minute time frame, so even here also we can check for any bullish divergence if possible, but as of now on plain chart everything remains the same. Whatever we have seen in a higher time frame, that remains same even here also. So on all time frames, price is trading below central pivot point, so that is a signal of a strong bearishness coming in Nifty. And until where that bearishness will continue? Until this point. So even in intraday time frame also, we have S2 at the same zone. So 10,555 to 10,550 is going to be a very strong support for Nifty. From there we can see a bounce back. Let's move to our next index, which is Bank Nifty. Even today, Bank Nifty is taking a very strong support near this zone. So until and unless this zone is not broken, where Bank Nifty took support for many days actually. So this is daily time frame chart, so each candle represents one day here. So until and unless Bank Nifty doesn't give a good close below this zone, we cannot be bearish. So from when it is taking support, from 4th of June until today, Bank Nifty took support near 26,200. So it is bearish only below 26,200. And on weekly time frame, let us see what it is saying. But before that, let's clear all the lines. So So on weekly time frame also, till now Bank Nifty did not exhibit a pure bearish setup. So starting from here, this was a long red candle. So starting from there, one should have anticipated bearishness to come, but neither of these three weekly candles, it was able to close below the low of this long red candle. So bearishness did not continue in Bank Nifty. So not only that, if we just extend this gap down onto the right side, so still price is trading in between this zone only. So until and unless it doesn't go up above this zone, it is not bullish, and until and unless it does not close below this, it cannot be bearish. So on weekly time frame, that is the major story that we can see. And on daily time frame, so this is a swing high, swing low, swing high, and again a swing low. So this zone now becomes a very important zone for Bank Nifty. So a kind of double top pattern, but this is not happening at the end of an uptrend. So if the same double top pattern, if it formed here, then it would have had a major importance. But as of now, there's no strength in this double top pattern. But only thing is, it can act as a strong support. Now let's see the pivot points, because today the first trading day, so it is trading way below the central pivot point. So already in bearish zone, starting from the first day of this month. So what we need to do is, we just need to determine at what point is it going to take support. Now based on pivot points and plane chart, if you see, the prior swing low is in confluence with the S1 of this month. So around 30 points of difference is there, but for an index above 25,000, 30 points of difference is not much a difference. So this zone, S1 of this month, is going to be a strong support for Bank Nifty. So it is coming down as of now, so we'll wait until it comes down to this area, and then we'll enter new bullish positions. And what should be our stop loss? Prior swing low should be our stop loss. So this prior swing low was a resistance for some of these candles, and here it acted as support. So when price comes here, we'll be on bullish side, keeping this as our stop loss. Now if it doesn't come here, takes a U-turn, and if it breaks this common high, then you should be on bullish side. So around 300 point of upward movement can be seen in Bank Nifty if this triple top pattern is taken out. So until the prior swing high, we can expect Bank Nifty to go. So bearish below this and bullish above this. Now this is one kind of setup, and the other kind of setup is, if it comes down to S1 and takes a U-turn, then again we'll be on bullish side, keeping this prior swing low as our stop loss. I'm going to lower time frame. So any of the index, Bank Nifty or Nifty, majorly it shows a divergence on lower time frame first. So always you need to check for this bullish or bearish divergence on lower time frame. So for bullish divergence, price needs to come down, but RSI should be on the higher side only. So price making a new low and RSI making a higher low, that we call it as a bullish divergence. And this, if it happens at pivot point support or natural support, that will hold a greater significance. So currently we don't have any bullish divergence as such, but since we are waiting until price comes down through this zone, then if we have any bullish divergence, that will hold a greater significance, and then we can be on the bullish side. Now enabling the pivot points. So currently, it is trading below the support level marked here. So this is first swing low, second one, and this is the current price. So current price is trading below the significant level here. So this significant level is nothing but the prior double bottom. So if it closes below this one first 1 hour candle, then immediately we can expect Bank Nifty coming down at least to this zone. So this is the prior support on hourly time frame, and we also have S1 of this week. So both in confluence will definitely act as a strong support to Bank Nifty, and this complete zone now becomes the first level of support for Bank Nifty. And if we get a bounce back from here, we can be on bullish side. So today, are there any trades possible? Oh, no bullish divergence as of now. So since this is the visible low on price, only from here only you need to check for any divergence. So here RSI is lower and here it is higher, so you should not consider this as a bullish divergence, because in between these two lows we already have a new low. So from this low you need to see if price is coming down and RSI remains higher, but as of now there is no such indication. So we'll straight away enable our pivot points. So from the starting of the day itself, if you see, the high of today is exactly the central pivot point of intraday. From there it faced the rejection and started to come down, but based on pivot points we cannot find a support here. And on 15 minute time frame, 26162 is the next level of support for Bank Nifty. So see the low of this candle. This is a hammer candlestick pattern, and the low of this candle will definitely act as a strong support to Bank Nifty, and that is around 26162. See here, even here also we have this support level at the same price. Now how can you trade in intraday for a shorter price targets? If there is a close below this 26162, you need to keep this as your first target and be on short side. And if it comes down here, takes a support and bounces back again, you need to be on bullish side, keeping this as your stop loss, 26080. And then from there, you need to be on bullish side. But for intraday purpose, the maximum target that you can keep is 26463, because that is a common high of many of the candles on 15 minute time frame. So mostly observe the charts of Nifty and Bank Nifty for a bullish divergence, then you will find greater opportunities in this current month. So since this month is result season, if you see historically, just open 2017 July's chart, 16 July chart, likewise open 10 years of historical data. If you see in July month, for the first half of the month it comes down, it falls heavily, takes support near a very strong support zone, and then again bounces back in the rest of the month. So even this year also we can expect the same to happen with Nifty. So we'll wait until it comes down, takes support near a very good significant level, and then we'll be on bullish side. So based on plain charts and pivot points, these are the levels for Nifty and Bank Nifty. So we shall take stocks from you all. If you have any stock in your mind, just put it here and we'll try to analyze that. So first is Vedanta. So Vedanta long term trend line support is already broken. Now in its upward journey, so if you see, it took support near the prior strongest support zone where we had a double top pattern, a double bottom pattern. So this is a triple bottom. From there it tried to bounce back, but this journey cannot be called bullish until this horizontal resistance as well as this trend line resistance is taken out. So on plain chart, this is the first point. So mostly you should be on bearish until these two resistances are not taken out. You should be on bearish, but even if you're on the bearish side, where should you enter? Only below 220. So when it goes up and again comes down, that would mean that the bulls which try to give support here, they'll be taken out. So once the bulls are taken out to square off their position, they'll start selling the stock below 220, and those bulls who are trying to sell the stock and new bears, both of them added, they'll give a very good bearish rally to Vedanta, and it will come down to 206. Instead, if it goes up and closes above this. So the bears at this position, so prior, if you see, this is a very strong resistance zone for Vedanta. Now after this supply zone, so the demand zone here, when it became supply zone, now once the price goes up again and closes above this supply zone, so that will in turn get converted into demand zone and price starts going up. So that is the best place to be on bullish side, which is around 245, and below 220 you can be on bearish side. Next is Tata Steel. So very clearly, the support zone which we had marked in our earlier market commentary sessions acted very well here. From there, we could see a very good bounce back in Tata Steel. And today, if you see, the resistance zone marked is acting very well. Not only that, we also have a trend line resistance in Tata Steel. So this, until price does not sustain above this trend line resistance, one cannot be bullish on Tata Steel. Now, if it closes above this trend line resistance, this high should be your first target, which is around 608.7. And again, a prior swing high, that should be your second target in Tata Steel. But should you be on bearish side now? No, that's not a correct idea. Only this support zone, once this is taken out, only then you should try and search for a bearish opportunity. But as of now, we can say that it is trying to start its bullish journey. And if you see, it is trading above the central pivot point of this month. So whatever the resistance which we are able to see now, that is going to be a short-term resistance for Tata Steel. So it will find, since it opened a huge gap up today, so people might be squaring off their positions. So this is just a squaring off their buy positions. So it will take support near the central pivot point or this candle's high. Then you can be on bullish side if you are an aggressive trader. Otherwise, you can just wait until this trend line resistance and this. So this horizontal resistance will not hold now because that was the central pivot point of prior month. So only wait until this trend line resistance is taken out, and then you can be on bullish side in Tata Steel. Next is TCS. So TCS clearly taking support near this trend line support. Now, when should be on bullish side? See here. So this is the common resistance. First open is equal to high of this candle. Next, price formed a shooting star at the same price level. This red candle had the same high. And even this, another shooting star, also had its high near the same price level. So 1870 should be your entry price. Or to be on safer side, the high of this candle should be your entry price to be on bullish side. Why are we on bullish side? Because price is taking support near this trend line, and this is going to be a ascending triangle pattern. So horizontal resistance and candles making higher low. So that is an ascending triangle pattern. And in ascending triangle, we'll be on bullish side only when it crosses the resistance zone. So none of the candle here, it made a good close above this resistance. So we'll wait until there is a good close above this resistance zone, and then we'll be on bullish side. Now your targets should be based on the R1 and R2 of this current month. So that is the best possible way you can trade here. Now, if it faces resistance near the same price zone again and again, starts coming down, so our bearish journey confirmation we'll get once candle closes below this trend line support, but we'll enter only once this central pivot point is taken out. And if you see, we also have a 20 period moving average here. So bullish above this resistance zone and bearish below central pivot point. Next is Reliance. Reliance is in between the journey. currently we cannot say where Reliance is heading to because it is in the middle of its journey. But based on pivot points, so it is trading below central pivot point. Only one conclusion can be made here. It is bullish above central pivot point. And until it is trading below central pivot point, it is bearish. And it is also trading below this 20 period moving average. So currently Reliance is bearish, but can we enter as of now? Then I would say definitely not, because it is inside the journey. But the best price level to enter would be the low of this candle, that is around 940.3. Why? Because from here a bearish journey started and again it bounced back. If it comes back again, so this becomes your significant level. So below this, definitely it is going to be bearish. And until what price is it going to be bearish? Until S1. So we have a double bottom pattern here, and we also have S1 at the same price level. So you should be on bearish side in Reliance below 940, and your first target of the month should be 915. Next is Tech Mahindra. So Tech Mahindra, a very clear resistance is seen here. So it is going to be long-term bullish only above 724 or 725. And to be on bearish side, it needs to close below this support zone. So this is the common low here. If you can see, for many of the candles, it acted as resistance. Once we had a green candle above this resistance zone, that acted as a strong support. So again, for Tech Mahindra to be on bearish side, it needs to close below 635, and to be on bullish side, it needs to close above 723. Next is Bajaj Auto. So Bajaj Auto, this trend line resistance is taken out today, but again it has a trend line resistance at 2915. Above that we have a horizontal resistance at 2942.6. So these trades can only be done in intraday basis. Now if you see, we had a very good bullish divergence here. So the low of this candle and low of this candle had a very near to same price. But if you see, RSI made a higher low. So that is a bullish divergence. We had a sales numbers coming out for all the auto sector, and most of the stocks did well. So to be on bullish side, this horizontal resistance needs to be taken out in Bajaj Auto. And for short term, you can keep 3044 as your first target. And above that, 3169 can be your next target in Bajaj Auto. But this will happen only when both these resistances are taken out. Now, if you see, we also have the R1 at the same zone. So above R1. Yes, so the pivot points are also coinciding with the said levels. This is R2 of this month and this is R1 of this month. So above R1, keep R2 as your target. The next stock is Maruti. So Maruti took a very clear support. So in our earlier market commentary on Friday, we marked this as our strong support zone, and it opened gap up today, but it is not able to sustain in this gap up. But on long term, bullishness can be seen in Maruti once this trend line resistance is taken out. Until then, we need to consider that it is trading in between this range only. So monthly basis, if you want to establish any position, current see this, it is taking support near the central pivot point. So if we can see any bounce back from this central pivot point, you can just start establishing your position with a small quantity. But once this trend line resistance is broken, you can enter with a good quantity there. LNT. LNT, there was a hammer pattern, and on Friday we could see a very good bullish rally. Now this was the strong support zone that we marked in our earlier market commentary, and that became S1 of this current month. So we'll wait until the central pivot point is taken out in LNT, and then we'll start establishing bullish positions in this, and we have a very big target coming up in LNT this month. So from around 1290 to 1380 can be our target in LNT for this month. Next is Yesbank. So Yesbank is trading below the central pivot point, and it is also facing resistance near the trend line resistance. So in this particular stock, we have a zone, trend line resistance zone, not just a single level, but it is a zone. And we need a very good close above this. And now we also need a very good close above the central pivot point. So we have highs coming up near the central pivot point, but we need a close above that. Then we can be on bullish side. Because on the downside, we have a very strong support in form of natural support and as well as S1 of this current month. Now from there, when price took a bounce back and bounced up again, we'll be bullish only above the price level of 342. So today and on Friday, if you see, both the candles are sharing the same high, 342, around the price level is around 342. So we'll be on bullish side only if Yesbank gives a good close above 342. Next is Indusind Bank. So Indusind Bank is showing a very strong resistance this month. There's a horizontal resistance, there's a trend line resistance, and there is also R1 of this month. So now price is trading below the central pivot point. So by the end of the day, we need to see if price takes support near the central pivot point or if it bounces back. So till now, until now, what we can see is the low of today and low of Friday are very much same, and even this candle and this candle are sharing the same low. So below this common low, Indusind Bank will be very bearish until 1880. So I am telling the price levels here. Indusind Bank is bearish below 1928, and you can keep your first target as 1880 for this month. And it can be bullish only above R1. Until then, we cannot establish our bullish positions here. So these are all the stocks and indices for today. Thank you all for joining.